Hi students, this is Mrs. Mukherjee from Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. I congratulate you as you have stepped in class 10th and getting several videos of several subjects and getting the opportunity of studying these subjects by sitting at home safely. Today I am explaining the chapter from geography, first chapter, Resource and Development. By using resource, the developmental process goes on. Development means the progress of the society, progress of the nation, progress of the world, all done by the use of resources. So what is resource? Whatever present in our environment and man can use it is resource, provided it should be technologically accessible. Means we should have adequate technology to access this resource. Secondly, it is economically feasible. The money required for exploring and converting the raw material into finished goods should be available. Third is culturally acceptable. While exploring the resource, it should be kept in mind that no violation of social customs is done. See, there are several resources. And to know all these resources, to study all these resources systematically, it is important to know, to classify the resources. And this is the classification of resources. Firstly, the resource has been classified into two major groups. One is natural resource and the second is human resource. Human resource is very important because human resource can make the use of other natural resources and participate in the developmental process. So this natural resource has been classified into two categories, renewable and non-renewable. Renewable again into two, continuous and biological. Continuous, that wind blow continuously, water flow continuously, we get sun rays continuously. So these come under continuous resource. Biological means has life, that is natural vegetation, forest, trees, and second, wildlife, any animal present. Non-renewable resource, again, has been classified into two, recyclable and non-recyclable. Non-renewable means once used, cannot be used again. But some non-renewable resource can be recyclable. For example, metals. After use of some particular material, after several years we can give this material a new look, new shape, so it can be recyclable. Non-recyclable, that is fossil fuel, coal, petroleum, natural gas, once burnt cannot be used again and again, so it is the non-recyclable, cannot be recycled. See, this was the classification of resources. Another classification of resources are there and also very important, as many questions can be asked from this classification of resources, that is based on the use of these resources. First, this classification is on the basis of the origin, that is biotic and abiotic. Biotic means the resources which has life, that is, for example, animals, human beings, trees, etc. Abiotic, all non-living things come under this abiotic resource. For example, metals, rocks, etc. Secondly, on the basis of exhaustibility. Renewable resource and non-renewable resource. Renewable resource, the resource which can be renewed and can be used again and again. For example, again, wildlife, forests, etc. non-renewable resource which cannot be renewed. For example, you have already gone through, that's a fossil fuel. Third, on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, first is individual resource. Every individual has some property of their own. For example, if an individual has house, has car, these things are the resource of that particular individual, and only that particular individual has the right to use these resources. Secondly, community resource. Community resource means the resource which can be used by the entire community. For example, if your society has a garden, that garden can be used by all the members of the society. There is no restriction. Third, national resource. National resource means the nation has the resource in its political boundary. Every mountains, forests, roadways, railways, everything that is within the political boundary of that nation is the resource of that particular nation. Besides this, in the water bodies, from the coast to 12 nautical miles in the oceans, this part is also come under the national resource. Beyond this 12 nautical miles, the nation has no right to use it. International resource, as I have already told you, the beyond 12 nautical miles in the ocean, nation cannot use it unless and until it can get the permission from the international organization. So after getting permission from the international organization, the nation can use the resource present in the ocean beyond 12 nautical miles. Fourth is, on the basis of the status of the development. First comes this potential resource, which are found in the region but have not been utilized. For example, the western part of India, that is western Rajasthan, Gujarat, has the first blowing wind and can be converted into wind energy but is not properly used. Second is developed resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization, and man is using this resource as per their requirement. Third comes stock. The resources which come under stock, that has the potential, but as we till date have no technology developed to explore these resources, so we cannot use these resources. Once this technology is developed, these resources will be used. For example, the water made up of two gases, hydrogen and oxygen, both are inflammable. If these two gases can be separated, can be used for several purposes. Then come reserves. Reserves are the resources come under the reserves that is kept in reserve when needed can be used these resources and so called reserves. Now see, resources, as there initially there was no restriction, few persons use this resource indiscriminately. So consequences, there is a depletion of resource because of this indiscriminate use of resources by few, and because of indiscriminate use, there has become a gap between the poor and rich. Rich become richer, poor become poorer. Third, environmental degradation, which is the most threatening condition, and taking care of this environmental degradation, when some environmentalists realized the after effects of indiscriminate use of resources, they come to conclusion that it is essential for an equitable distribution of resources so as to achieve a sustained quantity of life and global peace. By seeing this, some leaders assembled and attained a summit held in 1992 in Rio de Janeiro, where this very sensible issue was discussed and decided to ask every nation to protect their resources. And this agenda later came to be known as Agenda 21. This is for all for today's video. In the next video, I'll be explaining the resource planning and about the land resource and all. Thank you.